有着好莱坞明星般的俊朗外形，他执掌着全球最大英语培训机构的中国区帅印，英孚教育中国区 CEO 贝比然做客波士堂。
我跟你们讲讲，今天请到我们现场这位 boss 啊，不仅是一位很优秀的职业经理人，而且他更是一位了不起的老师。据说他的学生，如果全球算起来同时在线的话，有1500万。他是英孚教育中国区的 CEO Bill Fisher。费比然先生，一起看看大屏幕他的介绍。
费比然，英孚教育中国区 CEO， 1970年出生于美国新泽西州的 Red Bank， 1992年毕业于常春藤盟校之一的布朗大学，获计算机科学学士学位，其后在斯德哥尔摩经济学院攻读经济学硕士学位，1993年入职英孚教育机构，并开创英孚多媒体部。1997年创办 EnglishTom.com 英语教学网站，并担任总裁及首席执行官。2006年升任英孚中国区 CEO， 全面负责英孚在中国的运营与管理。英孚教育集团是全球最大的私人英语教育机构之一，主要致力于英语培训、留学旅游以及英语文化交流等领域。服务英孚15年的费比然先生，一直致力于用计算机技术设计新产品，升级人们的语言学习方式。
我们看一下，哪一个是你？哪一个？In the middle, right?
I was the baby.
Oh,
the baby.
Oh, 好可爱，好 cute. Which one? On the left, right?
Yeah.
That's your father, right?
That's my father on the right. Okay. That's my sister, and I'm the one on the right. See there?
左边那个还是啊，金发，一头金发一直没变过啊。呀，多可爱呀！哎，这个哦，哎，有点像这个。
Hair, I had long hair. Those are my two sisters.
这个就跟现在很像了哈。
啊，你好，欢迎。我叫 Bill Fisher. Please come in. I'd like to show you around my home very quickly. This is my living room. This is where I spend much of my time.I sit outside on the balcony at night, and during the days I like to read here on the sofa. So, that was my yoga class. I try and practice 2 or 3 times a week.And I find it, it's a really great sport for busy professionals. We tend to live a very fast lifestyle. And yoga has a great calming effect. It focuses you on breathing and on stretching and things that you don't normally think about when you're exercising. I really love it.
好，欢迎 Bill， 还有他的这个爵士音乐的演奏家们。
Take a look at the rest of the school, and follow me. We have interactive study lab, and this is where we have our students practice their hard language skills. So listening comprehension, speaking, grammar, reading and writing.So if you follow me over here, this is very important. We've got right here an EF English only zone. You can only speak English, so we try and get them to have fun and learn at the same time. Over here we have some study areas for students and some lounge areas. We have a cafe, and there you see some students doing homework and reading, hanging out, talking to each other. Here's one of our classes going on. This is a large class, but we have two types of classes. One that's very intensive, one-on-one, one-on-two study with the teacher, and then larger discussion areas where you can practice your conversational skills. And this is the heart of the school. This is our auditorium. And here we have a screen that comes down, and we show movies, and we watch the Olympics together, we show TV shows, and we do all of this to really create an English atmosphere. So we show a film, and we talk about it, and we get students to really interact with that language. And we've seen that that's been a really successful concept here in China. That was a quick tour of our People's Square Center. So I hope you enjoyed your tour. Thank you very much.
就是前不久，一个多月前，突然我们听到Bill在出差途中发生了一件事，而且他的这个突然倒下到医院待了两周，差不多都是经历一个生死的一个濒临生死的一个阶段。结果，所以我觉得特别好奇，发生了什么事情？是你工作压力太大了吗？然后你现在怎么那么正常呢？看起来什么都没发生过，到底发生了什么事情？
I flew to England, and I got a lung condition, and there was a lot of fluid in my lungs. It's quite serious, and the doctors told my parents that I had 30% chance of living. The first sight I saw were the four doctors who resuscitated me. I had been unconscious and on a respirator for about 5.5 days, not moving at all, and I didn't know where I was because I had just collapsed. And I looked up and I saw four doctors, and I was very confused, and they were very happy because I was awake, and I'll never forget their faces. They're drilled into my head in a very strange way, but they saved my life.
那个时候您父母在医院里陪着你，对吗？
My parents were in the hospital, but that was not the first memory, so they were the second memory, and I blacked out again after the doctors left me, and then my second memory was my parents standing beside me. And they had been there all week, so they came the day that I was put into the hospital.
他们哭了吗？
Yes, absolutely.
你也哭了?
Very emotional. It's a very unnatural thing to see your parents fearing for your life. It's not, if anything, it should be the reverse in the cycle of life. So it was a very strange and, in retrospect, a good experience because it helps you treasure that which you have in life. I've had an incredibly lucky life, and it's a real gift to be reminded of that in stone. But that which is woven into the lives of others. And so, the things that you think about when you realize you were very close to, not being here, it's all about people. It's 100% about people. It's about family, it's about your friends, my colleagues, the students that we have. I mean, the wonderful life that we have because we're a tribe here on Earth, and we're sort of here for each other, and that's been a real, as I said, a real gift to be reminded of. I had a tough time choosing in my personal life. I think I idolized my parents, my father, and business side. But Nelson Mandela, I think, is an amazing example of someone who just never gives up.
Yeah,
and I really respect what he's done.
确实是一个非常值得我们所有人尊敬的人物。我真的希望 Bill 在不太长的将来找到一个自己人生的幸福的伴侣，然后有一大家子的孩子，起码三个。叫做外表显迷茫，但内心一本账。难得糊涂啊，了不起的境界。对消费者好一点，然后把中国人学英语的欲望再激发起来一点。
我们给 Bill 准备的这个礼物，好像跟我们的几位观察员有这个异曲同工之妙哈。我们给您一幅画，这个人您认识吧
？Confucius。
对，孔夫子只有学生3000人，您有学生1500万，这是您比他强的地方。但是他的学问影响了所有的中国人，所以也希望 EF 有朝一日像孔夫子学习，总有一天也把您的事业。 成为教会全球人说英文。
What a great shot! Thank you so much.